everybody. We, day three of our trip. We got, about a half an hour before the shipper opens. So, we're sitting back here, drinking our coffee. Sheila's braiding her hair. Or playing with it. I don't know if she braided it or not. She's still got to get ready for work after pouting that I don't want to
get dressed.
But we got to drop this one off, and then once we get it dropped off, we got about a 7-hour drive to our next load, which don't pick up until tomorrow afternoon. So we got a little bit of free time and probably get a good night's sleep tonight again. We'll kind of touch base with you as the day goes on. So hope everybody has a good morning, and we'll talk to you a little bit later. Okay, guys, we're headed to Riverside, California. We got 6 skids to pick up, and it's about 4,500 pounds. Is it 4,800 pounds.
Very pretty. It's very pretty.
Yeah, beautiful here. We just got outside of Reno. Some beautiful sights through here. It's a lot prettier with the snow on it. It kind of gives it a little bit more character.
It don't look so much like dancing.
Yeah. Of course, there's no snow on the ground, just on the mountaintops here. Cassie's a little nervous now. I was trying to get the GoPro working, and I ended up dumping the floor out of my lap. I don't think she's very happy right now.
Trust issues.
Yeah, the bed in the back, they got a second bed in the back that folds in. I mean, any kind of stopping, if you have to stop at any fast speed or just have to brake real fast, that bed falls. And it's slightly fell on her a couple of times. And it fell and knocked Sheila in the head, what, 2 or 3 times? 4 times. I'm not doing it on purpose when I'm driving.
That's twice it.
I'm sticking to my story. Shows that it's shorter going through the business thing, but I got a feeling it's going to be slower. We can listen to her, but I think she reroutes us as far as a husband thing. We don't always trust her. There's been a few situations where she's taking us places that we shouldn't have been. Like,
really nice officer. I mean, we didn't know, and it didn't say. We didn't see the sign. He said there was a sign there.
I didn't even see it. I got the ticket for... what's it called?
The lane of traffic.
Hey, my argument was they was delaying me. I was trying to get out. There was too many of them coming. But he did say, compliment me on getting out of that street without taking off my curb.
He said it was set up for trucks not to be able to get in, but...
I got in there and out without no problem.
Except the ticket.
But with this size truck, I mean, it's not like a semi truck. It's just a street job. So it's not hard for us to get into some spots that, you know, semi trucks can get in and out.
First ticket of my entire life.
And she cried.
Yes! I can't say my driving record's perfect.
Princess was not happy.
Well, the first time. Well, I gotta tell you the first time.
Hold on, she's got pulled over more than once here. So.
Yes, I was in Iowa. First week out on the road, Tony and I was having a conversation. So after the conversation, he gets up and goes to bed. So, you know, one time he was transforming, going back to the back, I passed the scale house. Didn't realize I had passed the scale house without going in and being weighed. I get pulled over again.
Yeah, but the funny part is, she yells at me and says, honey, there's a cop behind me, and I think he's pulling me over. I said, and she's like, I'm doing the speed limit. I don't know why that he's pulling me over. And I said, did you go in the scale house? No.
But he was really nice.
Yeah.
I got off with a warning. And
she took her license. He took her license and said, well, you're going to have to follow me. And he escorted her all the way back to the scale house, the way you're in there.
And then he done an inspection of the truck.
Yes.
So,
check the log and everything. Let her off with a warning.
Believe me, I don't run past any more of them.
But she cried on that one too. I think it helped.
Will you shut up? Your mouth is rubber.
Oh, whatever.
You told me I have to tell everything.
Well, they want to know us.
No, they don't. They don't care if I cried.
Maybe they do.
No.
You be the judge. Do you care if she cries or not?
Do you care if I give him the finger? Because he's about to get it.
She's thinking it.
Really nice. He could have thumped the book at me. But he let me off in the morning.
Yep.
But I don't like Iowa and I don't like New Jersey.
Every place she gets in trouble, she don't want to go back to.
Nice shit happens.
And life goes on.
And life goes on.
Guys, you know, if you never really stop and take a look at, you know, what's around you, the beauty, you're missing out. The skies, the water, the mountains. There's a lot of beauty to be taken in around, you know. God gave us a lot of beautiful stuff to look at. Even, you know, man-made and building. Stuff like, there is some awesome looking architecture. Some funky looking architecture too, but there's something really awesome looking.
I owe you a toupee, honey.
My toupee. I got a Donald Trump thing going on. It's real, I swear. Just like
I
Donald
couldn't
Trump.
Resist. Hold on to your toupee. We find a lot of ways to amuse ourselves.
She's going to get the banger next.
I get a whole flock of them.
Whole flock. Thank you. everybody.
I keep my glasses on. Sorry. I don't want to have my glasses on.
You don't have glasses on anyway. Driving down the road.
No, that's different.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
She's so vain sometimes.
I'm vain. I admit it. I'm vain.
Look, she already got her makeup on this morning. Done her hair. We're getting ready to head out here. Being out here, it's nice, but it's killing our allergies. My eyes itch, her eyes itch. I think Cassie's even got a little bit of a allergy problem, so.
And she's even throwing up, so.
Yeah, she's getting a little sick, so. We'll touch base with you when we get ready to go, and then we'll head over and get loaded. We'll see you in a little bit.
Bye. Bye.